Hello and welcome to the How Do I Create a Matrix page in Microsoft Dynamics NAV 2013 R2. My name is Vyacheslav Babich. I'm a Microsoft Dynamics NAV MVP and I'm creating this video for you in cooperation with Microsoft and Platan, a Microsoft Dynamics training center from Belgium. At the end of this video, you will have a fully functional one-page matrix page which shows sales by salesperson data and allows you to filter and drill down in the page. The objective of this video is to explain the matrix pages, to explain the matrix management code unit, and also to create a matrix page. We will do this in 5 steps. In the first step, I will create a sub-page, which will be the matrix itself. In the second step, I will create the main page, which will control the matrix sub-page. In the third step, I will add code to manage column sets and captions in the matrix. In the fourth step, I will actually load the data into the matrix page. And finally, in the last step, I will add some filtering and drill down capabilities to my matrix page. In Microsoft Dynamics NAV 2013 R2, there are two types of matrix pages. The first is a two-page matrix. Let me show how that one looks. Analysis by dimensions is an example. So when I, for example, select an analysis view and click Edit Analysis View, what I see here is not the matrix itself, but the matrix filtering page. To actually access a matrix, I have to click Show Matrix, and then I see the matrix page. The matrix page can have up to 32 columns, so it means that if I want to select the previous 32 columns or the next 32 columns, in this example these would be periods, I would have to first close the matrix and then click on Next Set and then click Show Matrix again. So if I want to go to a previous set, I would click Previous Set, and then I can verify that the column set is changing down there in the matrix options again and again, and then I can click Show Matrix to actually see the matrix page. That was a two-page matrix. There is also one-page matrix, so for example if I go to Production Forecasts, what I see here is a one-page matrix where I have the filtering options fast tab, and I also have the matrix itself, and then still I have 32 columns. But then when I click Next Set or Previous Set, the columns change instantaneously within the page. Let's go on and create the sub-page. Whether you are creating a one-page or a two-page matrix, you typically start by creating the matrix page itself. So for my sales by salesperson matrix, I will start by using table salesperson purchaser, and I will also use a list part. Since I'm going to do a two-page matrix, I need a list part, not a list page. So I will click OK, and then I will add code and name. These will be my fixed columns in the matrix, and then I will have 32 more columns which will show the sales by salesperson. Here I will click Finish. Then what I will need is 32 columns. So those 32 columns are going to show that decimal information. So what I need here is a decimal variable. I will create this decimal variable. I will call it matrix cell data, and I will make it of type decimal, and also I'm going to set the dimensions property to 32. What I'm going to do then is create 32 rows, or actually 32 fields here, which are going to represent my matrix cell data. So I start by matrix cell data 1, then matrix cell data 2, and all the way up to matrix cell data 32. Of course, you don't have to create your 32 fields manually. You can copy them from an existing matrix page, but in that case you must make sure to either clean up any residual code in the field triggers, or you must make sure to copy all the necessary functions depending on what you need to do. Since I want to start off with a clean matrix page, I have created those 32 columns manually. The next step in the creation of these 32 columns is to actually specify the visible property. So if I take a look here, I have a visible expression property which is set to true. What I want to make sure is that I only have as many columns visible as there is actual matrix data. So sometimes you will have less than 32 columns. So in this case you have to hide any unnecessary columns. So here I will have field 1 visible, and then in the second I will have field 2 visible, etc. Here I will have to create up to 32 variables, so we'll have to start with field 1 visible, field 1 visible boolean, and then up to 32 boolean fields. So here I'm pasting 32 boolean fields. There is one more thing that I have to do, which is to specify the caption class. So I won't be explaining the caption management code unit here. What I'm going to say, that caption class of which starts with 3 comma means that whatever I provide as the remainder of the caption class is going to be used as the caption for my column. So here I'm just going to have matrix caption, and then again I will must match my my ordinal position, in this case this 32. So here I will have matrix caption of 32, which also means that I will have to declare another array. So let me declare another array. I will call it matrix caption. It's going to be text of 1024 characters, and I will define dimensions of 32. And then obviously my next step would be to make sure that this matrix caption is bound to the caption class property in this way. So I will start off by caption 32. On my 31st column I will have caption class of 31, and so on until I have it all the way. So when I have completed binding the caption class to each of the columns, my last step is to make sure that my field 1 through field 32 visible booleans are initially set to true. So what I'm going to do is define the on open page trigger, where I'm simply going to write field and then 1 to true 32 set to visible true. I have copied this piece of code from an existing matrix page, so you can do the same. You simply have to make sure that each of the field visibles are set to true. At this stage I'm ready to save my subpage. I will return to it later. I'm going to file, save, and then I'm going to give it an ID of 50001 and name sales by salesperson matrix, and I will click OK. Now that you have seen how to create the subpage, let's create the main page to control the matrix subpage. I will click New to start my new page wizard. Depending on what you want to achieve and how you want to relate your main and the subpage or matrix page, you may or may not want to use a source table and to use the wizard in this process. So in my simple example, I will not use much filtering, so I will start off with a blank page. So I will click OK. Then I'm going to define the control name for my container of content area type, and then I'm going to add one fast tab. In this fast tab, what I'm going to have is two controls. First one is going to be view by, which is going to be a filter specifying what are my columns. So here I'm going to set the option captions, as I'm going to enable view by different period lengths. So I'm going to have day, week, month, quarter, and year as my period lengths. And then I'm going to have another control, which I'm going to call column set. It's going to be non-editable, and it's just going to display the column set that is currently shown in my matrix page so that I can know which columns are shown. So here I'm going to declare two variables. First one is going to be column set. It's going to be text of length 1024, and the second one is going to be view by, and it's going to be option. And here I'm going to define the option string again: day, week, month, quarter, and year. Then I'm going to bind these two source expressions. So here I'm binding the view by, and here I'm binding the column set. And then my last step is going to be to add the part, which is going to be of page type. I will have to unindent it by one level to make sure it's on the same level as my fast tab. And then I'm going to bind it to my page 50,001, or sales by salesperson matrix. So this will show my matrix page as a subpage within my main page. And then I'm going to save my main page. I'm going to save it as 50,000, and I will call it sales by salesperson. Let me now run this page to see what I have done so far. So we'll click File, Run, and then what I see here is the sales by salesperson page. I have my sales by salesperson subpage. Here I have 32 columns. None of those 32 columns has any data or any captions. So what I'm going to do in my next step is going to make sure that I have my captions and my column sets properly assigned. My next step is to add code to manage column sets and captions within the matrix subpage. Since there are so many matrices in Microsoft Dynamics NAV which are handling period-based column sets, what I'm going to use is reuse existing code instead of writing my own code to handle that. So let's take a look at the code units. So here I have an interesting code unit called matrix management. And within this code unit, if I take a look at the function that it exposes, I can see that the primary purpose of this matrix management code unit is to actually handle different column sets. So if I have a matrix which, for example, works with period-based columns or dimension-based columns, I can use this matrix management code unit to handle those column sets. So here I'm going to use this generate period matrix data function, which is handling the generation of the column sets for period-based columns in matrices. So I'm going to close the matrix management code unit, and I'm going back to my page where I'm going to declare that matrix management code unit variable. The next step is going to be to make sure that I actually generate the necessary columns. So in my on open page trigger, I'm going to make sure that initially when the page is run, I can see the initial column set. So for that, I'm going to create a new global function. I'm going to call it set columns. And for now, let me leave the locals blank. So I will later declare some parameters to this this function. Here, what I'm going to do is I'm going to call my matrix management generate period matrix data function. So I'll click OK. And let's take a look at what parameters I need to pass into it. So I will take a look at the locals for this function. My first parameter is set wanted. And this is of option type. So it has option strings, which are initial, previous, same, etc., which is specifying which column set I want to generate. So what I want to do here is make sure that I pass the correct value to this. So I will go back to my page, and then I will first create a global variable, which I will call set wanted. It will be of option type. And I will declare, I will set the option string to the same set of values. Then what I'm going to do is make sure that my set columns also receives a parameter of type set wanted. It's going to again be of the option type, and it's going to use the same option string. And finally, I'm going to call this set columns function for my on open page trigger. So we'll call set columns and then set wanted initial. Then what I'm going to do is to provide all of the parameters to my generate period matrix data. The first one was set wanted. The next parameters are the maximum set length. Here I have to specify how many columns I want to generate. It is typically 32, but I don't want to hard code anything just in case Microsoft want to change the support for number of columns from 32 to something else. So here first I will create matrix column captions text 1024, which is going to have 32 elements in the first dimension. I'm going to receive the column captions from my from my matrix management code unit, and then I will pass that column caption set into my subpage. So here I'm using the array len of this matrix column captions function. Then my next step is to specify whether I want to use the names for captions. I do not, so I will pass false into that one. Then my next next parameter is period type. This is view by. Let's take a look whether my view by values, which are day, week, month, quarter, year, match the values accepted by generate period matrix data function. So I'm going to the function, I'm taking a look at the period type. So I have day, week, month, quarter, year. I also have a counting period, but in my sales by salesperson matrix I'm not interested in accounting periods. So I see that my view by variable actually matches the expected parameter values in my generate period matrix data function. Then I have date filter. So for now I do not want to provide any date filtering, but in case there will be any date filtering in the future, I will add my date filter text variable, and I will just paste it here, date filter. Then I will enter other, or actually pass other parameters. These are all by reference, so these are receiving the values out of my matrix management code unit. The first one is the primary key of the first record return in the set. The second one is the caption set itself, which is the set of, or actually array of 32 elements of type text. Then caption range, this is the one text variable which receives the description of which range is returned. I can use it to display it in my page. For that I have already prepared a variable in my page, as you remember. Then the current set length, which is telling me exactly how many columns are returned from the caption management, from the matrix management code unit. And then period records, which will receive the actual records of type date returned from my caption management, which are also an array of 32 elements. So let me pass those by reference parameters. So first I will declare all the necessary parameters. Primary key of the first record in the set is going to be text. Then I'm going to pass that one, so it's the next one is my caption set. This is my matrix column captions. Then I have my caption range. Then it is the length of how many I have received, so I will declare one column set length variable of type integer, so column set length. And finally, I have to declare a variable of type, I will call it matrix record. It will be of type record and will be of subtype date. And finally, I will set the dimensions to 32 on that variable as well. Matrix record. So at this stage, I have successfully called my generate period matrix data function. So let me try to compile to make sure that everything is okay. So it compiles nicely. What I have to do at this stage is make sure to pass all the required data from my sales by salesperson to the matrix page itself. Let's first save this page and then add the necessary function to my matrix sales by salesperson matrix page. I will design my sales by salesperson matrix, and then I will first add a function to receive all of matrix data. So I will just call it set matrix data. Within this function I will declare parameters that are passed from my parent page. So the first parameter is the column captions. It's text of 32 dimensions. The next one is my matrix records. So again, here I will make it by reference, so I will call it matrix rec. It will be record of type date. Again, it will be it will be 32 dimension elements in the first dimension. Then I will receive the date filter, so it will be text. And finally, I will receive the length, so column set length, which will specify the length of the columns that I have here. So this will be of type integer. Okay, then I will close my locals and I will declare the missing variables. So the first variable that I need to have here is obviously my matrix rec, so I will declare my matrix record. So it's record of subtype date. Date is also going to have 32 elements in the first dimension. And then I'm going to declare the body, or write the body of this set matrix data function. So first I will declare a local variable of type I. It's going to be I of type integer, which I'm going to use to iterate through 32 elements of the array to copy all of the necessary array elements between the arrays I have received and my local variables, or actually my variables in my current page. So I will write for I is 1 to array len of matrix rec to begin, and then what I'm going to first copy is the column captions. So I could have used the copy array function, but then I wouldn't have this piece of logic, which is if column captions of I is blank, then I want to add one space to it. So column, it's actually matrix caption of I is column captions of I. It's a one blank space, else matrix caption of I is column captions of I. Okay, I have made a mistake here, and I will save my function. Okay, the next part that I'm going to take care of is to copy the matrix record of I is matrix rec of I. And now I have copied also my record from the variable that I have received into my global variable of matrix record. Then I'm going to take care of the remaining two variables. I will can declare two global variables. First one is going to be page date filter. It's going to be text, and then the last one is going to be matrix column count. It's going to be of type integer, and then page date filter is date filter, and matrix column count is column set length. What I want to do at this stage is make sure that I hide any unnecessary columns. So what I'm going to do is create a function for that. So I'm creating show hide columns function, and I'm calling this show hide columns function. And what I'm going to do here is make sure that I do field one visible. It is only visible if matrix column count is larger than or equal to 1. And then I have to do it 32 times, so field 2 visible. So this is my complete function. Now I have called it from my set matrix data function, and then I will save my matrix page. me design my sales by salesperson page. So here I'm going to assign the name to my subpage. So I'm going to call it matrix subpage, and then I'm going to find current page and then controls matrix subpage. Then I'm going to call set matrix data function. So here what I will pass is matrix column captions, matrix record, date filter, and column set length. One more thing that I will do in this page is to also set the view, to handle the onValidate trigger on the view by, and I'm also going to call set columns set wanted initial. So what I need to have here is one core page dot update and then false. So we'll say save and then run the page again. So if I set week or month or quarter or whichever other period, it will be handled or actually shown within the matrix subpage. The last thing that I will do is to actually create the actions that enable me to navigate between the previous and next sets. So I will go to view page actions, then I will change the action container subtype to actions, action items, and then I will create four actions: previous set, previous column, next column, and next set. Then I'm going to define the properties and the triggers. So on the first action I will set the following properties. So first I will set the image to previous set. Then I'm going to promote this to my process category as a big icon, and then I'm going to call set columns set wanted previous. Then I'm going to set the same, or actually not exactly the same, on the previous column. So it's going to be previous record image, it's going to be promoted into the process category as big, and then it will be call set columns with set wanted set to previous column. And then I will do the same for the next two. So next column is going to be next record promoted, yes, the process category as big, it's set columns. And finally, next set, yes, process promoted as big, and set columns next. Then I will save my page and run it again. And then I also have my set management buttons up there, so I can see the column set here. If I move previous set, next set, or previous column and next column, then I can verify that my matrix subpage is actually showing the column set prepared by my matrix management code unit. In the fourth step, I will load the data in the matrix page and show it there. So let me now design my sales by salesperson matrix page to add the logic which actually calculates the sales by salesperson. So I will start by adding code to my on after get record trigger. So here what I have to do is I have to calculate for every salesperson shown in the page, which is my current record, which is the record for which I will get the on after get record trigger after each of them is received, but also for each of the periods shown in the page. So this is going to be a little bit complicated because I only have on after get record for the for salespeople, but not for the columns. So what I have to do is I have to create the logic to actually handle that. So what I'm going to do is create a new function which I'm going to call matrix on after get record, and this function will receive the current column number as a parameter. So in my on after get record, what I will do is I will add a variable to iterate, and then I will do for I is 1, 2, and then my matrix column count do. And then from here I will call matrix on after get record, and then I will specify which column I'm doing that for, so column I. And then from within this matrix on after get record, I'm actually going to calculate the value of the current cell in which I am. So what I will do here is I will declare a local variable which is going to be customer ledger entry, so it's going to be record of customer ledger entry subtype, and then I'm going to set the filters. So first I'm going to use the customer ledger entry and then make sure that I have a valid key. So here I have salesperson code and posting date. This is pretty good. So what I will do is cust ledge entry set current key, and then I'm going to pass the key name, and then what I'm going to do is set the adequate filters. So here I will do cust ledge entry set range salesperson code, which is my current record, which is salesperson, and then cust ledge entry set range, and then posting date. And then since I have my matrix record which has all of the periods, I can use my matrix record of current column number, and then I have period start, and then matrix record of current column number dot period end. And then finally what I have to do is I have to pass to calculate the totals. So here I will do cust ledge entry calc sums, and then the field that I want to calculate on, so it's going to be sales local currency field. And then I'm going to store that in my matrix cell data variable. So here matrix cell data current column number is customer ledger entry dot sales local currency, and then I will save my matrix subpage. Okay, I have made a typo, calc sums, I'm saving it, and then I'm ready to run my sales by salesperson matrix. So let me run my sales by salesperson matrix page. I'm running it, so I'm going to sum by year, and then let's take a look. Okay, here I do have some sales, and also I can see that I have sales in 2014 and 2015. And finally, let's create some useful functionality to this matrix page. So let's add filtering and drill down capabilities. First, I will add date filtering capabilities. So I will design my sales by salesperson page, and then I will simply add the control for my date filter variable. And then I'm going to add some business logic behind to actually handle what happens when the user enters the date filter. First, I will declare a variable for my application management code unit. Because that's the code unit which contains all the functionality for handling the date filters. Actually, it is calling the another code unit, but here I'm calling application management dot make date filter and then my date filter variable. I'm not interested in the return value, so I'm not testing for it. And finally, what I'm doing is set columns to make sure that actually my column set is updated. So here what I will do is set columns and then set wanted, and then I will save, and then I will run the page. And then I can see that my year 2014 is shown as my first year of my currently shown set. So I will save this page, and then I will close this page because I have done all I needed to do within this page. And then I'm going to focus on my sales by salesperson matrix. There are two things that I want to do here. First, I want to make sure that my my columns are not editable. So if I show what I refer to, I will run my matrix page again, and then I will show that my matrix data are editable. I want to prevent that. There are two ways how you can do that. First one is obviously to set editable to false on each of the columns, but a better way is to simply set the editable to false on the repeater itself. So I'm setting editable to false to prevent any kind of changes made by user during the viewing of the matrix page. And then finally, what I want to do is enable drill down on each of the matrix cell data columns. So first I will write my drill down function. So I will call it matrix drill down, and then I will define the body of that function. First, it will receive the current column number to indicate which column I'm within, and then I'm going to declare local variable for cust ledger entry, which is going to be again of customer ledger entry subtype. And then I'm going to write a very similar logic that I have written in the on after get record. So I'm simply copying the filters, and then what I will do is I will simply do page.run and then 0 and then cust ledge entry to show the default lookup page for this table. Okay, and then what I need to do is make sure that my drill down works on each of the columns. So what I have to do is for each of the columns I have first to define the drill down property. So I will do this for all of the pages, all of the columns. So now I have done that for all of my 32 columns. And one more thing is to write the on drill down trigger. So here I will call matrix drill down, and then here I will pass number 1, and then I will do it for all of my matrix columns. And now I have completed that for all of my 32 matrix columns. Now I will save my matrix page, I will close it, and then I will run my sales by salesperson to see if it actually works. So I run, and then I have to switch to a better view, so yearly view. And then let's verify, for example, for Peter Seto, I will drill down in year 2014. I can see that this belongs to Peter Sato, that for example for Peter Sato I have these in year 2015, and also in year 2016 I have nothing. That was it. In this rather long video I have shown how to create matrix pages within a one-page matrix design, and also how to load the data, how to manage the captions, and finally how to add some filtering and drill down capabilities. I hope you liked this video, and please join me in other videos in the How Do I series for Microsoft Dynamics NAV 2013 R2.